When I gaze at the cross, I often consider it in terms of a tapestry. What God had communicated to man in terms of direct revelation through the prophets and through the law had not rescued man from his ultimate disease, which is rebellion and sin. But when God saw fit at the appointed time, the Bible says, just in the nick of time, it says, right at the exact moment when the Lord saw fit, he sent Jesus, his son, the physical embodiment of all of the fullness and majesty of God, so that he might ascend a cross and do what? Paint the most brilliant portrait of God's love for man imaginable in the blood of his son. The Bible even describes the grotesque nature of the punishment that he took as causing men to look away. In Isaiah chapter 53, it says that he was not beautiful, speaking of Jesus, that he was smitten, that he was pulled apart, that he was trampled upon in a real sense, and so much so that he was like one from whom men turn their eyes. And yet here is the Holy Spirit saying, look back, because in the misery of the cross is found the beauty of the full measure, the depth, the wideness, and the extent of God's love for us. And to those who are perishing, Paul says, to those who reject it, it's foolishness. It sounds like utter nonsense. Apart from the Holy Spirit grabbing a hold of someone's heart, how crazy it must sound to say, a man from Nazareth who millennia ago died for your sin. But what wonder it is when we accept as a starting point for real wisdom the fact that God has revealed himself in Jesus Christ, and we begin to conceptualize and see and hear the ring of truth echoing throughout the ages from the sounds of the hammering of the nails at the cross. Because at once it defines and it demands. While the world declares wisdom apart from God, Jesus reveals the complex wisdom of God in the artful demonstration of his love at the cross.